Batch balancing is a process where the amount of ingredients to use in a production batch is calculated from the concentration of active ingredients in selected product batches. To get an understanding of this, let's take a closer look at a formula that has been set up for batch balancing. This formula consists of four ingredients, A, B, C, and D. For making 100 liters of a finished product, 20 liters of ingredient A is needed, 30 liters of ingredient B, 10 liters of ingredient C, and 40 liters of ingredient D. Each line has an ingredient type. The type active indicates that the ingredient, in this case item number B, is set up to have a concentration of an active ingredient. Let's navigate to the product to see how the active ingredient is set up. The active ingredient is modeled with the use of a product-specific attribute. A product-specific attribute has a minimum, maximum, and a target level. The target level represents the estimated concentration of the active ingredient in percent. The maximum and minimum value represents the accepted deviation from the target and can, for example, be used as an accepted tolerance at product receipt. A product can only have one active ingredient. So after defining the product-specific batch attribute, it needs to be classified as the active ingredient of the product. This is done by associating the product-specific batch attribute as a base attribute to the product. Here is the base attribute for the product. Here is also set up how the batch attribute value is normally recorded as part of the purchase receipt process or as part of the quality order management process. I'll now navigate back to the formula to explain the use of the remaining ingredient types. The type compensating compensates the quantity of the active ingredient. The relation between an active ingredient and a compensating ingredient is set with a compensating principle. As you can see, you need to point to the active ingredient you want to compensate. In the compensating principle, you also specify a factor. If the factor is positive, it is indicated that a higher quantity of the compensating ingredient is needed if the active ingredient has a higher concentration than the target value. This is called a compensating principle with a complementary effect. If the factor is negative, it is indicated that a lower quantity of compensating ingredient is needed if the active ingredient has a higher concentration than the target value. This is called a compensating principle with an opposing effect. The type filler is used for an ingredient that is neutral. This type is typically used to reach the desired output quantity of the finished product. Adjustments to the filler quantities are calculated based on variations in the active and compensating ingredients. The type none indicates that the amount of ingredient used in a production batch will be independent on the concentration of the amount of active ingredients in the selected batches. In this example, ingredient B, C, and D, are all set up for the warehouse management processes, whereas ingredient A is not. Now let's go to a batch order and go through the batch balancing process. Here is a batch order for making 100 liters of a finished good. The batch order formula shows the ingredients. The batch order is in status estimated. I'm now going to release the order. After the batch order is released, an info log indicates that no materials were released to the warehouse. This is because the batch order is applicable for batch balancing. A batch order is applicable for batch balancing when it has at least one item in the formula which with the ingredient type active. These type of orders are released to warehouse as part of the batch balancing process. When starting the batch order, the menu item for batch balancing is enabled. When selecting batch balancing, the batch balancing page is opened. This page gives an overview of the formula ingredients. When I select the row for the active ingredient B, I see the available batches in the inventory in the lower section of the page. In this case, there are two available batches that are on hand. Batch B has a concentration of 35%, which exceeds the target value of 30. Batch B2 has a concentration of 25% and is lower than target. I can select the batches I want to use for the batch order. Let's try to select batch B1. After I have selected the batch, I can now select the menu item Batch Balance Ingredients and make the batch balancing calculation. The balance quantities for the ingredients has now been calculated. The balance quantity for the active ingredient B is 25.71, which is lower than the estimated quantity of 30. As batch B1 has a higher concentration than the target value, a lower quantity is needed. The balance quantity of the compensating ingredient is 14.72 and higher than the estimated quantity of 10. This indicates that the compensating principles between the active and compensating ingredient is complementary. A higher concentration than target requires more compensating ingredient. The quantity of the filler ingredient is a little less than the estimated amount. The quantity of the filler ingredient is adjusted so the sum of the balance quantities for the ingredients equals the batch size of 100 liters. After the calculation of the balance quantities has been processed, the ingredients can now be released to warehouse. I do that by selecting the menu item Confirm and Release to Warehouse. The ingredients enabled for the warehouse management processes will be released to warehouse. For the ingredients not enabled for the warehouse management processes, a picking list journal will be created. I can now confirm the dialog. Let's first look at the resulting warehouse work. Here is the work for the three ingredients B, C, and D. Notice that the work contains the batch number that was selected in the batch balancing process for ingredient B. Now let's look at the picking list journal for ingredient A. Here is the picking list journal created for the non-warehouse enabled item for ingredient A. The batch balancing process has now been completed and the batch order can now be processed.